We could maybe like put it. Yeah, I don't know. What do you reckon? The Temple of Ars. Oh, dearie me. You have entertained me today. No, I don't think spacing them out is going to look good. Or would you like me to? I don't know. You tell me. What do you reckon, guys? Is I don't, what I don't, oh shit, I just lobbed the arm, mate. I just lobbed it. I think I managed to catch it. I did, just. There you go, Ares. Thank you very much for your picture, mate. So, Ares in chat linked a picture of a Greek temple about 3 weeks ago. And this is what we came up with. It's not finished. Not finished, but... Our new gods. Fuck you, blood gods. That's all right. What do you reckon, Ares? You happy with that, mate? Have we got the Ares seal of approval? We are going to have to light this up like a mofo, mate. What's that, Sky? That means going up and down the mats for me. It's a bit outside my skill set, right, Sky? That's about as good as we're gonna get in it. Oh Jesus. That's alright, innit? That's alright, mate. Pretty damn chuffed with that. What we're gonna do, we'll do the mood lighting inside. So what we're, because I mean it is fucking dark, innit? We've always got the bathtub. So we'll fill this with water. I genuinely don't know if we're going to be able to. We will try it with buckets, but I have a horrible feeling that it's going to end really badly. I think it's just too big an area to fill up with buckets. The roof we're going to do with candles. Farm looks great, though. It's really cool, doesn't it? Oh, shit. Is the S upside down? I don't know, is it? Does it matter? That's it. Turn the old thing down. It's put the S on upside down. Fucking, it's ruined. It's ruined. Throw it in the bin. Let's start a new cake. Yeah, so what I'm thinking is, you see this recess here? I'm thinking like a candle opposite each pillar would just add like a really nice, I mean, I don't know. Let's try it. The thing is, I do really like the torches. I love the flickery flame that they provide. I don't think the candles are quite as effective on that. But candles are going to look better in a temple, aren't they? So the front ramp should be a bit wider. Out here, you mean? Yeah, I mean, we could do that. That'd be ever so easy, mate. I only did it because it was like too wide going up to the stairs. Otherwise, if you had the ramp here, you hit a pillar. Jesus Christ, look at that. That's mad, isn't it? It's like a multi-story car park. I suppose it technically is, in a way. It's a multi-story farm. Oh, whoa! Check that. Oh, my God. That is awesome, mate. Oh, wow. Check that out. Oh, I freaking it. That is madness, man. It has a real sense of scale there, isn't there? Definitely need more spotlights. Millions of them. Right, how do we make candles? Do we need tallow or something, don't we? Plant fibres and tallow. So we have got an absolute metric to animal fat. So let's go get that bubbling up. Oh, we're not doing it with no wood. Throw that in there. How much can I make? 217. Let's not be stupid. Let's make... Oh, what do you reckon? Should we say I don't know, 50 to start with. How are we doing for food? Let's have some lunch. Nearly back to 250 wellness. Fill it with turds. So we're gonna have a shit bath. The outside looks like a temple to Mary, the inside to Hades. We did say a bit of Cthulhu was about to infiltrate the server, so... What's going on here? Get these bad boys back. And what was it, Al? Plant fiber, right? Oop, shit. Probably should take this time. Oh, I ran out of... fuel! Not having that amount, right? Not on your Nelly! Okay, I think that before we start the Sphinx, right? We're very close to finishing the Temple of Ares, okay? So, like, as in very close. But before we start the Sphinx, we've got to finish off the metro system, because it's driving me mad. Build an aqueduct. That's a nice idea. We can certainly have an aqueduct around the edge. I quite like the sound of that, actually. That sounds pretty cool. An acropolis. Watch out for the coach tours. I watched the Final Destination not that long back, a couple of 3 weeks back, or it might have been more recent, actually. And there's that, I think it's the first one, where they're having this right sort of melodramatic moment, and the girl who's not played a hugely big role in it suddenly becomes really vocal, and she's basically just telling them all to shut the fuck up and chill out, and literally she just sort of throws her hands in the air, just like, oh, you're just such a bunch of whiners. And she walks out and she just literally gets hit by this motherfucking coach just that completely splats her. I can just imagine that. We'll avoid the horde, we'll avoid the zombie bears, and then we'll get hit by a tour bus. Right outside the Temple of Ares, right? It would be really nice. It's something that we could actually look around at with the Unity assets. It would be really nice to actually be able to have some sculptured blocks in. I don't know if any of you have ever spent any time on the Unity store. The prices range from just insanity, like thousands of dollars, all the way down to, like, you know, I don't think I've seen anything for 60 cents, but, you know, certainly around £1 to £2. There's some really good stuff out there. Tallow. Candles. Right, let's make a load of candles, and then we can go and actually start placing. Should we do the top first? Let's go. So let's see what the candles look like. Might as well do it while it's night time, because light works very strangely in this game, doesn't it? It's like you can be deep, deep underground at 12 o'clock midday, and it's nice. You know, you can sort of see the tunnel system reasonably well, even if you're like 60 blocks down. And then night will descend, and it actually gets darker in the tunnel. It's very strange. It's always been something that's thrown me a little bit. Right, so I originally said we'd put them... They actually fit on the floor. Kind of nice, I reckon. Let's put three in. That's nice, mate. That is not stupid.
Roulette, perhaps, while we wait.
Dude, what? Yeah, let me get this side in. I'm pretty chuffed with that, actually. I didn't think they were going to look that good. I like the actual... I'll tell you what, these candles are up there with fucking modded Skyrim candles, mate. The actual flame flicker is brilliant. Shit, that looks like that was one out. You want a little bit of roulette, do you? Hang on a sec. Oh, that's nice, mate. That's nice. That's scary. That's a bit freaky, actually.
Ooh, you bugger!
That looks wicked. It looks like it just goes on for miles, doesn't it? That's cool. Oh dear. What the fuck is biofuel? We made a little bit yesterday. It's a very, very expensive way, or very laborious way of making gas for your mini bike. And whatever else needs gas, so the auger, the chainsaw, things like that. What about building a coliseum to fight the zombies? We've sort of got that. We've got the Grum Pyramid back at Caliper City for our kind of gladiatorial arena. Now let me get the old roulette out. There you go. Now don't forget, if you double bet, and you double bet for a total of more than 100 Grum Bombs, I will remove your Grum Bomb winnings and deduct a percentage of your original account value. Do not double or multi-bet for more than 100 Grum Bombs total. It will be obvious to everybody in chat that you have tried to cheat the system. Do not try it. Oh no. You have been warned. Thank you for the follow, Grande. Much appreciated, mate. How you doing? Where's... Oh, no. I suppose what we could do, we could put the candle... I mean, the candles don't actually offer much of a glow. And I'll be honest, did we actually try candles in the original Hellbite Temple? See, they look great in terms of a little feature in the darkness, but they don't actually offer a huge amount of illumination, whereas the torches are significantly better for that. So I'm quite happy with this upstairs, because I think it should be a dark sort of loft area. I feel like it with just the light on the gun. Hello? Quite spooky, innit? Imagine if the game was like this like fucking zombies coming out of the darkness at you.
Hello?
Thank you, Swank in it. Swank in it. Swank in it, bro! Yeah, I mean, what I'm going to try, Dren, I'm actually going to try putting, downstairs, I'm actually going to put a row of torches on one of the rear sides of the pillars. We'll see, if it actually gives us any additional illumination. I don't think it's going to be efficient enough, though. I think if we place them at the right height, we'll get a real sense of sort of height down there. That I'm very happy with, though. That's perfect. No need to tinker about with that whatsoever. Let's try on one sort of side at the back here. Have the winners come up yet? Because obviously if we've got people that have double bet, we'll have to deduct their Grum Bombs, I'm afraid. Ooh. I think we don't need the one on the floor. I think the one on the floor needs to come out here. That could look pretty good. That could look pretty good. Let me just sort out this roulette nonsense. Do we have a winning thingy? Did it not come up with the winners? Oh fuck! Grumbot not announcing the winners, he didn't do it last time either. I wonder, was that on the last spin? That's weird, guys. That's weird. Let me just try something. Two times with. I'm really sorry. I did say to you, until this thing gets ironed out, I'm not being held responsible. It's a strange system, this thing. It's very buggy at the minute. Although it should, I didn't realise you said last time that it didn't give grum bombs though, to be fair. That is strange. That is really strange. I'll tell you what we'll do. There we go. That's a bit naughty, but... Let's bring roulette back up.
Hello?
Let's test it. I mean, anybody wants to risk it? I'm not gonna refund on this, so anyone wants to risk it for a biscuit now. Give that a whirl. Let's see what happens. I wonder if it's because I'm closing the window down too early, or if it's... Oh, shit, hang on. We've got to worry up here. I wonder if we do it on every other pillar, or do you think we need to do it on every pillar? I'm running out of quality night time here, aren't I? So let's try it on every pillar. We will take it all the way to the top, I think. Oh, shit. Ah! Oh, I've got hot wax in me eyeball. Bloody hell, mate. I've heard of an eyebrow wax, but fucking Ada, mate. Right, with girlfriend. Probably cheaper than where she does it. Oh, shit, we're out of day. We're out of night time. Looks kind of nice, though. I don't know, should we take out, maybe we could take out, like, this one. And this one. Let me just do this, guys, and then what we can have a look at it tonight, can't we? Oh, shit. Put that up there. Have to do a bit of nerdy polling in there. I think what's happened is because they tried to be smart with this game. What they've done is even though you can see it's 22. Black on screen. That I can see that. Obviously, you can't see it. So they've kind of built in a bit of a delay on it. So that's what I need to do, is not do it until that happens. So thank you very much for that. Yeah, I think what's happening is I think I'm actually closing it too early. So that's actually my fault. So thus the free grum bombs to all there. So my apologies. I have to wait for that message to come up. Damn. I'd like one there. Means I'd have to put them like this. Ow. They're all cabinets, aren't they? Look, the whole floor is made of cabinets. I was like, what the hell just happened? That might look quite nice. Three on each. Let's go for that. God damn, the things we get up to, right? Yeah. It's a very nice glow, isn't it? I do like the candle. That is pretty, like, that's pretty. Oh, fuck. Did I just... pulls that up. So annoying. No! Dude! That's okay, isn't it? Nightmarish. That's proper playing with my my head. That is. It's like they don't quite go where you want them to. So I remember this problem with the old fort. Fuck it. When we did these underneath the main sniper tower. I What's that, Fortune? What did you do? How's the puppet? He's all right, thank you, Fastlox. Yeah, he's doing all right, mate. He's a lot happier, a lot happier. He was a bit weird last night. He was very moany and cry. He was just very whimpery and very much wanted attention. As I suppose you'd expect after a traumatic ordeal like that, mate. But yeah, he's all right, thanks. He seems to be back to his normal self. Bouncing around. It's all too confusing, Sky. It's all too confusing. Do we have some more tally? Shit, we need loads more, don't we? Bloody hell, fire. I'll tell you what, let's just... that might be a bit overkill. What else do we use? We're never going to use this crap for fuel production, are we? Not while we've got all that beautiful shale downstairs. And we can always replace this if we want to, so... let's just pop a little bit in there. Cool. 5 minutes. Is this what? The tribunal hall where we kill the children? Jesus Christ, that's a bit dark in it, mate. Bloody hell. It's where I was going to sit and eat my donuts and have a cup of coffee. I wasn't expecting child sacrifices or anything, dude. God blimey, what did you have for breakfast, mate? Hang on, I want that, don't I? Candle. Flaming arrows uses tallow. Oh shit, did they? Hardly ever use them anymore, mate. Shame, actually. I've got a few on my hotbar, haven't I? I think we've got 15, look. Oh, hang on a sec. Where's that gonna go? What do you reckon? Do we leave it at that? I quite like the fact you can actually see them. You know, when you first come in, it kind of looks quite good. Now, we need 1, 2, 3. Hang on, let's have a count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 14. So we need 21 candles to finish that off. So should we just do it and get it out of the way? And then, to be honest, the only thing that we then have left to do is the external stuff. You know, like the peach accent blocks all around the sort of top. I honestly didn't think we'd get this done today. I was hopeful that we'd, but at the same time, I think I was in a bit of denial. But, especially when we came on and we got the tier 6 horde coming. I kind of thought, yeah, that's not going to happen. I think if we push on, we can probably get a little bit more of the metro system done. All right. I think it's when you try to place them. They essentially go to the bottom of the block, don't they? So I think... my issues with placing them is I'm actually trying to place them higher than they really are. So I suppose it makes sense because upstairs when we place them, they literally sat on the floor, didn't they? And we're just going to make a couple of candles short. So close, Ares. So close, mate. It's amazing how time consuming the simplest things are, right? Oh, just go stick a couple of candles in the temple. 3 hours later, he's running around trying to kill a sheep. I need more tallow! There's not even a sheep in the fucking game, mate. Am I staying for the next horde? I don't know when it is, mate. When is the next one? Yeah, we slightly overdid the tallow, didn't we? Let's make 3 candles. Let's go and pull the... It's going to frustrate me because I know that this is actually going to take quite a while. But what do you reckon? About 2 hours to do all the outside? Like, being realistic? I was going to say like 15 minutes. It's not even close, is it? I reckon you're looking a good couple of hours. From a distance. From a distance, the temple is done. No one's going to know that it's not quite right on that side. Yeah. It's amazing what a difference these blocks on the top of the pillars make. Really does. Massive difference. And we're still going to be able to run... I mean, that was my worry. We're still going to be able to run the adobe pillars around the edge. Fill the pool with milk. I tell you what, mate, if I could, I would, because the water looks freaking horrible, mate. The water is just shoddy. The water is like... there's no way to describe it, mate. It looks like a British beach, to be honest. It's foul. It really is. We had to get rid of it, Alex. And in fact, actually, technically, I didn't need to get rid of it. But Junior Stripe in chat, Stripe, has volunteered 1,000 Grum Bombs for us to hit creative mode and treat ourselves to another cactus. If you could place bookshelves, that would be an awesome study where you can go. Yeah, it'd be nice, actually, yeah. That would be nice. Did you know there's actually cigarettes and cigars in the game? Who was it who told me about this? They're actually already in there. They're classed as a dev-only item. There are actually cigars already in the game. Empty one bucket into the pool, refill the bucket from a different location, rinse and repeat. It don't work, Stripe. We tried it, mate. We tried it with the old swimming pool, remember? Just doesn't work. I'd almost argue it's a little bit too bright up at the top. But it's pretty cool, though. I mean, I'm not going to worry about a little bit of ambient lighting too much. Can you have candles underwater? I have no idea, mate. I suppose the candle technically does take up a whole block, so you might end up with one of those weird situations where it looks like the candle's kind of in its own square protected bubble. Can you show you that? Yeah, I can show it. Yeah. Oh. We could just sacrifice the children. I was going to say you shouldn't have been able to find one, Dread. Yeah, I went into creative mode and checked that out. Yeah, there's actually a nice big fat juicy stubby, isn't there? That's the ceiling. What's the matter, Alex? Pretty big, isn't it? It's cool. We can still reach this elevator as well, which is awesome. Kind of like this. Pretty cool. We should have a little hatch so we can actually get out onto the roof. To be honest, Glyph, there's not a huge amount here. I mean, this is just our little outpost. I mean that's by far our biggest structure out here in the desert compound. We've obviously got the Shytamid. Essentially, this is our toilet. So, you know, we don't half-ass things. No pun intended. Oh, what about these lights? We really need to do that at night time, don't we? That's the farm. That's the main compound. I really don't know what to do with this, to be honest, because as much as it's tempting to actually put the lights in, whether or not they work, I can't help but feel it's a huge amount of resources for me to waste. But at least aesthetically, it would look finished, wouldn't it? It's going to look like some sort of hideous spider lobster creature. Ow. By the time it's done, isn't it? The underground stuff, to be honest, that's the next thing on the agenda, mate. It's going to be a bit dull. It's not the most exciting thing in the world because it's already pretty much already mapped out. But that is kind of where I'm headed, actually. Let me just put everything away. Knife and the blocks and things away. Wood. Tallow can go in there. Plant fiber in there. Tallow. Let's pop that in. What would that even go? Well, I'll tell you what, let's put it next to that. What do we need then? So we're going to want all the concrete. So let's take this and let's also start mixing up some new cement. We're going to get attacked a lot here, I think, because we're going to have the forges running. I really got no cement, guys. Is that for real? What the hell? Hang on, something's not right here, is it? Oh no. Did I balls up? Oh, fucking hell. What happened to all the cement we had? Oh shit, this is shocking. We're going to have to risk it. We're going to have to risk the Daphne invasion, aren't we? We're going to have to get them both smelting up cement, or it's going to take us forever. Oh, I hate doing this. Two forges is just asking for trouble. Ah, there's not even any stone. Oh, hang on. There's a lady in here, look. But not enough. Nowhere near enough rebar either. Oh, dude. How did we fall so far behind? Shocking. That's very unlike us, to be honest. I think I use quite a lot of concrete doing that. The mine entrance, I probably used a bit more there than I kind of realised. What's that, Nathan? You're on day 49 and it's 21:27. You'll be fine. You might not even get a horde, mate. It might glitch out on you. Okay, let's join the two great tunnels. What's that? A brick light... Bricklit archway. I'm not sure what you mean, dude. The problem I've got, mate, is the
Hello?
God, that works out. Yeah, the problem we've got is the electric's like super unreliable at the moment. All right, Leckle, be Leckle. How you doing, mate? What we'll do is we'll put it down. Get all the rebar down. What little rebar we've got, and then we'll go and grab the nail gun from the battle box. You're right, Kruick. How are you, mate? Well, if Elagod had managed to get his signs working, I think he had a bit of He had a brainwave and it didn't look like it worked out. We could have had some fuck off signs all the way around the perimeter of the build. Actually, something that I would like to do today, I think we did start smelting up the forged iron for it. I'd like to go and do the chain link fences with a little bit of barbed wire, even if it's just on like one little tiny strip of 10 or something. We've just literally just modded in the chain link stuff, haven't we? Well, added the recipe so we can actually craft it. Oh, I see, chicks. So I see what you're saying, mate. Yeah, that sounds nice, dude. Hey, what's going on there? Gonna need a lot more rebar, aren't we? And this is just one little stretch, man. The other tunnel system goes for fucking miles.
Hello?
You're right, Lady Bellum. Thank you very much for the follow. Sand and more stone, which means more cement. Trouble is, the two forges really will almost certainly attract Daphnes, but to be honest, I think the pyramid is like one of the best defenses against Daphnes. In order to try to get to the forges, they kind of naturally, because it's central to the pyramid, or to the back end of the pyramid, they seem to naturally just go up the slopes. They tend to hit like a couple of rows of spikes. Thank you for the follow, Arc Quantum. Much appreciated.
Hello.
Thank you for the follow, Pretty Princess. You're a pretty princess. I tell you, if you do an expansive Hello? Tunnel system, Goliath, the best tip I can give you is don't make it out of concrete, mate. You can actually get some much nicer effects just using sort of like wood and things like that. Not only is concrete bloody expensive, mate, and extremely slow going, but it can also get quite dull. The reason that I like the concrete, obviously the fact that originally I wanted it as quite a sheltered, you know, quite a protective tunnel system. Back when we started with Caliper City, the whole point was that we could travel underground at night, and I was very worried about the zombies like tunneling down and getting into the tunnel system. It seemed to be like a non-issue, to be honest. But the other thing that I do like about the concrete is it's very bright and light. You know, it's quite a pale block. Wood can get a little bit dark, but having said that, you stick a couple of torches with the wood, and that you know, some of the effects you can get are amazing. I certainly wouldn't recommend doing it like this, mate. Way too time consuming. So, to be honest, this all started off as a bit of a Half-Life thing. Do you know when you first enter the very first Half-Life 1, when you go through the transit system? I was kind of trying to replicate that sort of effect, because I've always thought that was amazing. It's one of the best starts to a game ever. In fact, to be honest, I actually started Half-Life that many times just to witness the Metro entrance. It's like all the automated vehicles and things underneath you. It was absolutely mind-blowing at the time. 583 cement. We take... Just going to cook up what little we've already got. Oh, look, we've already got some... That's why we did cook it up. I thought it was unlike us. Any more bloody... Yeah, we did the side bits, didn't we? Right, we'll do this. We'll go and eat. We'll get the nail gun. Might even take a 2-minute break and grab a cold drink, I think. It's thirsty work doing the Grum Butty junctions. Wow. Job done. So that then leads into this one last little strip here. So there's actually not that much to do. Not for this bit. I mean, all right. It's not done yet, but not too bad. To be honest, chicks, I've got no idea, mate. A lot of people suggest that we do it the other way. I just don't know, dude. I've always built with the rebar and the wood. I just like doing it that way, mate. So even if I found out it was probably like half as expensive, I'd still probably carry on doing it this way, mate. I just like it. I like the fact that you get the rebar, you put it down, and then you sort of put the plywood around it, and then you pour the concrete in. I don't know. It was amazing when I first saw it in the game. You know, a lot of the blocks you just simply upgrade. I was always really impressed with the concrete, but when I first saw it, I just thought it was amazing that they'd gone to all the trouble of sort of, yeah, it graphically changed as you did it. And then the fact that it's also wet and it dries, it's just a level of detail that's like mind-blowing. I think it's incredible. The other reason I like the rebar method as well is, it's not so obvious here, but you know, if we're building something pretty big, the beauty of the rebar is if I put it down wrong, I can just pick it back up, mate. Especially, I mean, it was a really good point when we did this transition down here where we've actually got one tunnel that's one block higher than another just because of the natural landscape. So if I'd been using concrete, I'd have actually spent ages chipping stuff out because I never quite get it right first time. So the rebar really saves me on that. Yeah, we'll do the lights every 10 like we normally do. We just need a little bit more rebar, some curved rebar. We're going to get the nail gun. You want to do a massive underground base? Do it in concrete then, mate. If it's going to be your main base, do it in concrete. Don't skimp out. Ignore what I said earlier, mate. You got your work out for you now, ain't you, mate? 100 of that. And 100 of these, pretty please. Okay, let's go and grab our friend the nail gun. I don't think we left it in here. Oh, we did. We did leave it in there. So wood is going to be the one thing that stops us here, isn't it? Oof, blimey. Rebar uses less concrete but more iron. Oh, does it really? I'm playing it on the PC with mods added, unknown. I mean, if you're playing on the PC, you can have the lifts. You can mod them in. If you're playing on the console, that's not an option at present, unfortunately. Oh, that sounds really cool, actually, Goliath. That sounds really cool, mate. Why don't you try, what about this? This is a bit of a bonkers idea. Why don't you try to like recreate Vault 101? It's something that, it was an idea that I did have ages and ages and ages ago. But I'm not a massive fan these days of sitting down in the tunnels. So you can have that one for free, mate. What about an absolutely perfect replica of Vault 101? Get into modding, you could even get stuff like big vault doors in there or something. It's one of the most satisfying things I have to say to you. Oh, fuck. Oh, I did the floor, didn't I, mate? Oh, shit. Yeah, well spotted, dude. Sorry, mate. We even just said, haven't we? Shit, it's really dark in here. I can't see squat. Shit, let's count them. Well, let's go from here. So, let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, God, 8, 9, 10. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. God, they're hard to see, aren't they? Wet concrete. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, that'd be great. That's fine. A little bit of extra illumination in there. Light shooting off down there. Thank you for that, mate. Well spotted. Let's dig these out, otherwise I'm going to fall in them. Okay.
Hello?
Thank you for the follow, Sven. How you doing, mate? I think I meant to do that one. Did we start cooking up some rebar? We did, didn't we? Oh, dearie me. Oh, cough's back. Yeah, I was going to take the rebar out, mate. I completely forgot. Too busy going click 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 click. Aren't concrete blocks better? What do you mean, Ozzy? These are concrete blocks, mate. These are reinforced concrete. What am I gonna need? 4 glass, isn't it? So I think we use the business glass. Let's just argue. Oh, hang on, we've got no. Need sand.
Shit. Hello.
All right. Well, I tell you what. Let's go and backfill them. Excuse me. Let's go and backfill them. Hello, Andy. Thank you for the follow, mate. What's that? Was it only 1500? I don't know what you mean, mate. You're talking about the durability? Yeah, these are wet. These are wet concrete, though, don't forget. When this is wet for about 24 hours, and then it becomes solid. I didn't need that one. God, it is getting hot again. It's a mad day today, I tell you. Started off nice, and then it's like, remember like a couple of weeks back here in the UK, it was like super humid. Feels like we're gonna have another like super hot, sticky weekend. I mean, I don't mind it being hot, but it's when it's the humidity, you know, it's just nasty. Okay, bish bash bosh, job done. Let's go and get the glass blocks and the torches. It looks weird, doesn't it, while it's drying? I'm trying to get like a bit of a checker pattern. Got a fan on every vapor. Yeah, it's nasty, isn't it, mate? It's kind of sneaking up on me a little bit. Glass. Blocks. Let's make 5 of those. I think I've actually got a torch in here, so we'll get rid of that. We've got wood on us, we just need some coal. Hello, 1098 with cheese. How are you, sir? Let's grab the torch. 4 of those. Stick that back. Here we go. Oh shit, I didn't get the blocks, did I? Be risk breaking a leg. You know when you're in a hurry, the number of times I thought, let's just go for it, never ends well, does it? Is it hot there in Ireland as well? Oh, you're from Ireland, are you, mate?
Hello?
Thank you for the folly, Flamey Cloud! You didn't know about the drawing. Yeah, it's, I was just saying, actually, you probably just popped on, didn't you? It's one of the really incredible extra little touches that, you know, it's what makes this game so magical to me.
Hello?
You know, a lot of people slag it off for all the wrong reasons. But there's so many nice touches to it. Now, if you ever find yourself on this server and you end up in one of my horrendously complicated tunnels, just follow the torches. The torches will always be on the side that leads you to the main fort. So if you're lost and you're not sure which way to go and you want to get home, the torch is on that side, it means that's the way home. We've been doing that since day one, haven't we? Right, let's get the rest of this tunnel knocked up. How long has it all taken to build? I don't know about the desert outpost, mate. I kind of regret not putting a clock on it, to be honest, because we get asked that a lot. It's quite a long time, mate. It's not happened overnight. We do stream a lot. Every single minute of it has been streamed, apart from occasionally I'll nip on at the back end of the day and just do some boring stuff. I've probably, in total, played probably, what, an hour and a half to 2 hours at most off stream. Mainly knocking out concrete while I watch Marco Polo. There was the generator room. I think I had to knock out, what was it, about 30, 40 blocks of concrete. So I just whacked Marco Polo on Netflix and just sat there with a pickaxe. Just, oh my God. Get on with it, dude. This is what a mistake means in a build like this. You're in central US and it's got to be 96 degrees Fahrenheit today with high humidity. Perfect day for a 10-mile hike. Jesus, mate. Well, I hope you enjoy your hike. How long does the stream usually go? It's a bit variable, mate. How long have we been on today? We've been on for about 6.5 hours today, haven't we? We normally stop at about 3 o'clock, but we'll probably carry on for a little bit today. I wanted to start doing some evening streams, but I always fancy playing something a little bit different of an evening.
Stream has been up for,
so I might do like No Man's
hours,
Sky when that
comes out. 35 minutes, 30 seconds.
Okay. I think we normally do that. Do we normally do that? I don't think we do we? We have there. I really would prefer an angled blocking, but actually, seeing as we're going to have the garage door, let's sod it. Let's leave it as is. Yeah, we'll be all right. How do you know what tier the hordes are going to be? It's straightforward, mate. They literally just in cycles of 7, dude. So a tier 1 horde is day 7. A tier horde is day 14. And it all resets on day 49. So day 49 is a tier 7. The 7 sevens. And day 56 is a tier 1. And Fortune did like a really cool spreadsheet so that we can just like copy paste it into that little chat thing. Fuck, lights again. Yeah, good one, mate. Good one. My bad. It's alright. Still wet. We'll be okay, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10. Nice one, dude. That's actually about spot in the middle anyway, isn't it? Yeah, that'll look... I mean, even if it's not, I think... Sometimes the angle can play tricks with you. Sometimes it's better not to overthink it and just go with what looks natural. Oh shit, I did not want to do that. Yeah, there's been quite a few builds where, you know, if you get too mathematical with it, you can actually end up... I'm trying to think what it was that we were doing. Oh, it was the Hellbike chamber. And it was one of those really weird sort of moments where in your head you're thinking mathematically that isn't right and it's not going to look right. So we actually sort of changed to, if you like, the crucifix. And it instantly, your mind just went, no. That's not right. And yet, mathematically, it made perfect sense. It's really weird. I think a lot of it is to do because of the field of view in the game. I think sometimes it kind of just throws you off a little bit. Is that Fort Fuck It there? It is, isn't it? Lock. The light, apparently not. Shit, we've actually done it, guys. What was that, Nemesis? You didn't know about the hordes, had tears. Yeah, I mean, yeah, absolutely, dude. Yeah, it's, shit. What am I out of? Wood. Of all the things to run out of. God's law, innit, eh? So close, so close. You're right, steady toking. Look at that, it's great with the old sunset there, look. Over the Shytamid. Tell you what I'm just going to do very quickly, because this door has not been repaired for a while. Well, it doesn't need repairing. Unusual. Let's pop the rebar back, and the torches back, and the glass blocks back. We don't need any of that malarkey, do we? Stone back in here.
Hello?
We're going to need so much adobe for the Sphinx. It is just ridiculous. In fact, I don't even want to think about how much we're going to need. It is shocking. I don't know if any of you have seen the plans for the Sphinx, but it is huge. I mean, the chances of us making a fuck up early on, which means loads of it is going to have to be smashed out, it's crazy. I mean, the Sphinx is like probably three times the size of this thing. Well, it's easily three times the size of that thing. Grum, why do you use... what do you use for the lights on the floor? Just torches, mate. Just plain old cheap as chips, normal torches, these things. And then I put... I can hear a fucking bear, dude. Oh no, look, it's a Daphne, and she's right where we said we didn't want them to cut. Oh, that is bad, dude. That, oh shit, hang on. Oh, dude! I'd love to know what happens if we close this on a zombie. Oh, that's another Daphne! What happened? Did it squash her or not? I've always wanted to try that. I'm not sure if it did or not, to be quite honest. Oh, fuck. We've got ferals, dogs. We're in deep shit here, guys. I'll try it. Do a quick run around here. Oh, shit. We got... Oh, dudes! We got a Daphne shit. Oh, no. Disaster has struck. Dogs are coming up. Oh, my lord, mate. Here they come. Why are they not fucking dying? What the fuck, bro? Christ. Shoot them, mate. Oh, God, what the fuck is going on, man? This is what I was saying about, Have we got that double shot thing going on, or is that someone else over here shooting? Oh, we've got the double shot thing going on. That's weird, isn't it? Yeah, it's like sounds like a double action shotgun. You can hear it with the arrows as well. That's mad. Oh no! Look what they're doing to the. Oh no, dudes! This is catastrophic. We're gonna lose Ares, mate. Where the hell is she? Oh shit! No! No! It's gonna fall. We've lost the pillar. Look! Oh no, dudes! Holy crap! We've offended the blood gods. All is not good. We have actually lost the support pillar, guys. Here comes Mojo, look. Cheers, Mojo. Got the Temple of Ares is being defended. God damn, son. Right, we need to put one of those spike picks over here then, don't we? Careful, careful. I'm worried about there being another screamer. Something wrong with my guns, mate. What the fuck just made... Oh my god, dude. Did you really just make that horrendous noise? These things have been pervious to shotguns, mate. Thanks, Mojo. He came out of his bunker to help. Oh shit, look at that, guys. Holy fuck monkeys, mate. Oh my god, that is bloody frightening.
Hello?
Wow, dude. Just freaking wow, mate. See, all those people that say, like, does the game not keep you on your toes? Anything can happen, mate. Don't worry, Ares, we got you covered. I was a little bit worried when I saw that support pillar fall out, mate. Oh, my lordy lord. God. Damn, man. God damn. It looks like it, didn't it, chicks? I think the blood gods sent a little preemptive strike at me there. Well, we need to build a big bloody pit like we did with a farm. That'll solve that fucking problem. Right, let's get this thing fixed as fast as we can.
Hello?
Mojo's got a little bunker just over here. I think what actually happened, I think Pina's chucked him out of the main compound that they were working on. I think he kept eating his dodgy bacon, mate. He's got his eggy farts. So he was chucked out. Right, what are we going to need? We're going to want clay and sand, pillars, blocks. I think that's it. If I throw that and that in. God damn, son. A great first defense of the Temple of Ares there. Excellent work. Thank you very much, Mojo. I need to log because I've got that weird gun glitch. I'm not sure what actually causes that, to be honest. It's only the second time I've ever had it. Oh no, I didn't. I just upgraded it to bloody concrete, look. AJ's still shooting. What's going on? Oh, what's going on over here? Oh my Gideon! Loads up here, mate. There's a copper burying in there.
Hello?
I think I need to get myself an AK. Thank you, Kentivar! Look at this. Mind you, I suppose actually he's doing us a favour. He's actually digging up the sand for us to put the flagstone down. Woo! See you later, Buckshot. Take care, dude. Wow. Scary times. Very scary times. So that pillar goes in here then, right? Yep. Oh, jeez. I was actually very concerned when I saw that pillar pop. Like, as in very concerned. Definitely need to shore up defences on this. We'll just do the same as we did with the farm. I don't think we need to worry about anything fancier than that. As long as we make it quite wide. Is that actually a block or something? Is it just... bloody hell. Imagine if we'd lost the back end of the Temple of Ares. Oh my lord. It doesn't even bear thinking about, does it? They smashed that fast though.
Hello?
Cheeky little Daphne. Thank you for the follow, established though. Right, we better start digging a big bloody pit. Let's just go and have a little look at the sort of what we did back at the farm so we can sort of gauge a bit of an idea on what we're going to do. As long as we build the exit here, should be okay.